Hello, Victor Nygren here, or Mr. Nygren, as I'm known as a modder. Alright, and I'm also known as Mr. Nygren on YouTube. Anyway, I'm playing Ragnarök Online, a game I have never played before. I've only played it in the morning and a few days ago. However, I have all the 10 volumes of the Manwha, because the Manwha, which is a South Korean manga, and when mangas are made in Korea, they are called Manwhas. And the Manwha or manga, let's say manga because more people know what that is. So the Ragnarök manga, it originally ran in Korea between 1995 and 2001. However, the manga arrived in Sweden in 2005, so I read it in 2005. And they run in Sweden for the 10 volumes were between 2005 and 2007. And the 10th volume ended with continues in the next volume, and that volume never came, because in 2001 the creator of the manga started to work on this game, Ragnarök Online, which is an MMORPG or massive online multiplayer role-playing game. And when he started to work on this game full time, he stopped to work on the manga, and as such the manga was never finished. Then after the game came an anime that was based on the anime and not the game. An anime came that was based on the game and not the manga, because the manga wasn't finished, while the game had a lot more to, you know, base an anime on. But the anime is very much like the game. The characters level up, etc. And when they are higher levels, they can beat stronger enemies and such. And also, it's more childish. The manga was bloody, and the characters looked more mature. It was a more mature story as well. I prefer the manga over the anime. I watched the anime 2 times, but and it's good, but I would have preferred the manga as an anime, and that's no joke. But problem is that the creator never finished it, so it would end with continues in the next volume. However, back to the game. I've never played the game before, but I tried to play it a few days ago, and I also played it in the morning. Now, the first character that I created, this character, Chaos Runeknight, I made a mistake of playing through the training area, the training grounds, but I missed out on the battleground, and instead went to the city of Prontera, way too soon. I was level 4, so I had no chance, and I can't go back to the training grounds after I have left it. So, in other words, I messed up with this character and went to Prontera far before I was ready for it, so I had to restart it. And then I restarted it with this character, Chaos the Runeknight, which is a swordsman here. So I played through the entire novice section of the game, but I was still a noob at playing the game, so I didn't know how to, you know, use the skills and everything, even though I read every text of every character, but I still couldn't, you know, bring up the skill menu and such. Of course I could bring up the Alt S tab, so I could get access to the skills, but I couldn't bring up the F1 to F9 buttons, because I didn't know exactly how to do that. I forgot what the NPC had said, but it was button F12, I believe. Anyway, so I played the entire morning and parts of the night with this character, and leveled the character up to level 16. And thanks to another player, female character, but probably a male player. Anyway, thanks to a veteran player who started a new character where he was going to play as a biochemist or blacksmith or something like that. That player saw that I had trouble with the game, so he helped me with explaining how to do things. So thanks to him I was able to finally figure out how to, you know, use the skills and finish the quests of the battleground, etc. And then after that I could on my own, you know, finish all the novice stuff and do the test for to become a swordsman, and then I finally became a swordsman. So that's done. But the problem was that the recording stopped for some reason, and I realized that most of my playthrough as the novice was not recorded. So I have no choice but to restart it. So in other words, I will use this character, I think, when I finally reach the swordsman section again, when I become a swordsman. But I will replay the novice part with a new character, because the gameplay wasn't recorded for most of the playthrough. So I played for many hours just to find that nothing was recorded. Or most of it wasn't recorded anyways. We need to restart it. So I have played the novice section of the game now, and I know how things work. So it's not the same as if I just played it for the first time anymore, as I have already played the novice part, and as such it will be more effective now and faster to play through. So it's in my opinion, it's better to record everything again than to use material that takes forever before I even get anywhere. Alright, so we have a new character here. We have this character, and its name is Chaos Runeknight. I don't like the name, but I have already used Chaos Runeknight and Chaos the Runeknight. Alright, let's start the game. So we are in the game, we can zoom in like this. The characters are in 2D, but the world is in 3D, so you can see. You can also scroll like this with the button, so we can see the world and the character from different angles. Let's speak to this girl here. I can hardly see the text. Sprocky, I think. Let's speak to her. Sprocky. Hello there. Welcome to the world of Ragnarok Online. My name is Sprocky, and I'm in charge of giving you the basic guide to the gameplay. Click on the next button or press enter to proceed with the conversation. Sprocky. I will give you the information on the basic controls, all the basic moves, item selection and attack use, left click and attack use, Sprocky. I will not try to sound like a female, I will just use my ordinary voice. Okay, Sprocky, I will give you the information on the basic controls, all the basic moves, item selection and attack use. I will give you the information on the basic controls. All the basic moves, item selection and attack use left click of the mouse. Alright. So, and here it shows. Move and attack, left click. Use the left click to move and attack. Sprocky, first of all, let's try moving around. Do you see that wooden bridge to the right? Walk over that bridge and you will see a castle used as the training center. I will be waiting for you inside. Please come to the castle by yourself. Quest window. Catch pouring. Find my fish. I'm hungry. Give me fish. Quest status. Find my fish. Click Alt plus U. Alright. I will be waiting for you in the training center across the bridge. You can open the quest info window by pressing Alt U. Have you checked the quest info window? I'll be waiting in the training center across the bridge. Alright. So here's the quest. Let's double click on it. Then this will come up. We can move it around. And then we have it here. Summary, across the bridge you can see a castle that is used as training grounds for novices. You are asked to go there. Go to the castle and talk to Spraggy. Alright, and here we have another text. Welcome to Novice Training Center, welcome. Here's the bridge. Speak to the guards here. Training center guard. Come in. I would like to welcome you to the training center. In here you can prepare yourself for future adventures throughout the Ragnarök world. Close. Welcome to the training center. You are now in the outer courtyard. Please go inside the castle to begin your training. Reason I won't sound like a female, etc. It's because it's too much to do that for every character. And I'm not the best at speaking English. It's better if I use my own voice. Alright, let's speak to Spraggy again. And we went up a level, I believe. We are level 2 now. Spraggy, great. Now you know how to move and talk to others, right? Welcome to our training center. Here you are going to learn all the basics of the gameplay and battle. Of course, the training process is optional, so if you want to go straight to the big world, that's fine. However, you will miss all the advantages you can get in the training center. Begin the training, of course. I will guide you to the Novice Training Center. Instructor Braid will be waiting for you inside. He will help you learn more about the game. Please talk to him. You got a quest, Novice. Training from Spraggy. Please check in the quest info window. Alright. Okay, Novice Training. Spraggy has sent you to the Novice Training Center and asked you to find Instructor Braid. Talk to Instructor Braid. He is here. Instructor Braid. Great, I'm your instructor, Braid. You completed a given quest successfully. So hereby I will reward you with experience points. And I got some experience points there. I'm level 3 in base level and 2 in job level. Instructor Braid, experience points you've earned from hunting or finishing quests can be checked anytime on the experience bar located in the upper left corner of your screen. Yeah. Experience bar for your base level and experience bar for job level. Instructor Braid, let me continue. Our next step is about items and equipment. First, take these. These are the basic equipment and recovery potions. Instructor Braid, in the upper left corner below the basic info window, you can find the inventory icon. In the upper left corner below the basic info window, you can find the inventory icon. Right. Let's just do this. Alt E, and we get to the inventory. We have stuff, we have items, novice potions, 500 of them, they will heal us. We have the gear menu, where we have tailored novice ninja suit, an exclusive armor for new adventurers, impossible to refine this item, class armor, defense 25, weight 0.1, required level, none, and jobs novice. Alright, I need to be a novice to use it. Somber novice hood. An exclusive garment for new adventurers. Impossible to refine this item. Class garment, defense 4, etc. etc. for a novice. Let's just put them on. And novice slippers. Exclusive shoe for new adventurers. Impossible to refine this item. Alright, for novices. And then we have novice false eggshell. An exclusive helmet for new adventurers. Impossible to find this item. And for the novice only as well. All this stuff is mostly for the novice only. We have a novice main gouge. An exclusive main gouge for new adventurers. Account bound. Attack 45. Property neutral. Novice jobs. Let's put that on as well. We have a novice guard. An exclusive shield for new adventurers. Impossible to refine this item. Class shield, defense 20. Jobs, novice. We have a cotton shirt. A simple, sturdily made shirt of cotton. Class armor. Defense 10, weight 10. Jobs all. We don't need that as we have the other one equipped. And we have a knife too. We choose the other weapon. This one has attack 17, weight 40. While the other one on Alt Q, you bring up this menu, it has how much attack? 45, so it was way better. Alright, we're done there. Let's close that and speak to him again. And we went up a level, a job level. So we are level 3, job, and 4 base. Instructor Braid, you're all set. Nice work. I will give you a field manual and bubblegum as a reward. You don't need these in here, but they will come in handy later. Next, we will talk about hotkeys. Press the F12 key on your keyboard. A box with 9 slots will pop up. If you drag the right corner of the hotkey window, you will be able to see more slots. So there, it's this one, 9 keys. And then drag, I have already done this in with another character, so it was automatically up from the start. I have no interest in removing it. But this is what you get with 9 slots, and then you can drag it to get the rest. Instructor Braid, how to use it is simple. The F1 to F9 keys are the designated hotkeys. Just drag a skill or an item onto the hotkey window and press a corresponding key to use them. So F1, F2, etc. all the way to F9. And here are the skills, first aid, play dead, and you can move them here to easily use them using the F1, F2, F3, etc. buttons. Add item, skill, or equipment to hotkey. You can add an item too, like a potion. Or an equipment. Left click and drag. Alright. Info. Register skills or items can be used or equipped just by pressing the corresponding key. You can customize the hotkeys to use any key you want. Register your favorite skills and items to use them easily. It is time to learn a new skill. Somewhere in this room, there's a person called Jinha. He will teach you the first aid skill. Go find Jinha and learn the first aid skill. Then come back to me. So this is Jinha. Jinha, hello, how can I help you? Tell me about first aid. Jinha, sure. First aid is the skill that converts your SP or skill points into HP or hit points when you are in danger. So basically it takes SP points from this meter and adds HP points to this meter instead. Jinha, the recovery amount is small. Still, it may help you not to faint from a critical hit. You can open the skill window by pressing the skill button below the basic info window. The hotkey is Alt S for Alt skill. Why don't you try it yourself? Good. Now you know how to use the first aid skill. So move on to the next step. Go back to Instructor Braid and show him what you learned here. So Alt S, as we can see, we have basic skill, first aid, and play dead, and then we have Miss Glennis here without any skills. Instructor Braid, now you learn the first aid skill. Just as I told you before, by registering it onto the hotkey window, you can use the skill fast and easy. And that's it, that's all I can teach you. Do you see the exit to the east? Move on to the next room. There will be the next instructor waiting for you. We will be seeing each other soon enough, but for now, go there and get some new information. You've come a long fine this far. It is not much, but take this as the reward. Now we are here. And this girl, Chocolate, has something to say. Chocolate, welcome. I will tell you about people you can meet in any town. Some of them are very useful to new adventurers. I'll tell you about agents from the Kafra Corporation and their rival Santa. When you visit the town for the first time, ask soldiers to show you the most interesting places. I will also tell you about the comfy inns. Chocolate. Well then, let's hear from each of the guys. Go talk to the Kafra agent first. Alright. Problematic to move there. So this is the Kafra agent. Kafra agent, hello. I was dispatched here by the head office to tell trainees like you all about the Kafra Corporation. Ours is the world's largest company with a long and distinguished history. We are always ready to help adventurers. I will tell you about the Kafra services that are used most frequently. Save, storage, and teleport. Save service determines the location where you will revive after being defeated in battle. Your respawn point is the last place where you have saved. If you want to return there without dying, use a butterfly wing. Save service is free, so don't hesitate to use it any time you like. Next is about the storage service. We provide you a warehouse where you can store your items and retrieve them from any Kafra agent. It's unreasonable to carry all your items with you if you don't need them right away. Please use our storage and keep your stuff safe and secure. Storage service is provided for a small fee that may differ from town to town. However, in order to use it, your basic skills must be at least level 6. Storage is divided into 3 sections, consumables, equipment, and other items. There are maximum 300 inventory slots there. It means that you can store up to 300 kinds of items. Remember too that each equipable item takes up 1 slot. The maximum number of items that can be placed in the Kafra storage is 30,000. Also, keep in mind that the storage is shared for every character on the account. We also provide a teleport service to make your journey easier when you are trying to move a long distance. With our help, your trip will be safer and more comfortable. Take note that the places you can teleport to vary according to the town you are currently in. That is all for our never-ending support, and we are working hard to repay our debt to our customers. Shall I repeat something? No, thank you. I hope you are satisfied with my explanation of the Kafra services. Yeah, it's fine. Chocolate, you've learned a lot about the Kafra service, huh? From now on you can use it whenever you need to. By the way, if you get tired of training and decide to go to the big world, talk to the Kafra agent again. However, it is impossible to come back to the training center once you leave it. Next is the Kafra's rival, Sonda Corporation. Its agents specialize in events. Well, why don't you talk to them yourself? Right, I need to go drink something. I return soon. Alright, so I'm back. We are going to speak to the Sonda, event staff agent. Sonda event staff. Hello there. We the Sonda Corporation are working in the service and event industry. Our services are pretty much the same as those provided by the CAFRA. Our staff is always ready to support you with the storage, save and teleport services. If there's no CAFRA agent around you, we will do it instead. If there's no CAFRA agent around you, we will do it instead. We also work on special events in Alberta. We are providing a network for the events. I hope that you can meet our staff in Alberta. That's it for now. We will probably meet in the future. Most of us wear red coats, just like mine. You can find us in places where CAFRA doesn't work. Okay. Now you must talk to the soldier. They may seem insignificant, but can be a great help when the time comes. Proclet, I brought here a soldier guide from Frontera. Ask him about his work. Alright, soldier. We usually guard the town gates. Soldier, we usually guard the town gates. If it's your first time in town, talk to us to get some useful tips. Soldier, our clothes may vary, but all of us will be happy to show you around town. Soldier, ask us about any place of interest in town, and we will show you where it is located with a plus mark on your minimap. That way you can reach your destination much easier. Soldier, if you want to go to a town now, ask the CAFRA agent right here. She will teleport you there in no time. I don't want that. I did that mistake before. Chocolate, have you learned much from the soldier? Good. The last part of my course will be about inns. You can find one in any town. You can rest in inns or hotels for a fee. That will fully recover your hit points and skill points. Nice feature, isn't it? And we went up a level. We are now level 5 in base level and level 4 in job level. Also, in towns you'll find merchants selling various items, but I'm sure you won't have any problem with them. And that will be all. As a reward for completing my course, I will give you free tickets for CAFRA storage and teleport service. They will come in handy. Now it's time for the real combat. The combat training course is taught by Instructor Braid. I will send you to him right away. Alright, so we are at the training course. In the first time I played this game, I made the mistake of going to the city of Frontera and skipping this part. We are attacked, so I need to move. Those green things are very aggressive. Fuck those green little bugs. So, item. Had to use that so we won't die. Alright, let's place this here so we can use the potions easily with F1. Need to kill all those green insects. They are the only aggressive ones. Alright, let's speak to this guy. We'll need to kill that one too. Let's move the camera like this so we can see anything. So they are called Fabies, I think. Alright, let's speak to Braid. Braid, now that you know the theory, it's time for real practice. Here I'll teach you how to battle. If you want to attack a monster, click on it with the left mouse button, LMB. One click, one hit. Also, you can click Ctrl LMB, left mouse button is LMB, to auto-attack a monster until the battle is over. Auto-attack can be enabled by typing the /NC command in the chat window. Then let's get to the hunting. Please hunt porings around here and get some yellow bees. Battle from Braid. Please check it in the quest info window. We need to kill that thing. Alright, we're done there. Alt U. We have a battle quest, first battle. Braid has asked you to hunt porings. Alright, kill one poring. Let's do it. Done. The porings are these pink little blobs. Alright, let's speak to Braid again. Job level up. We are level 5 in job level and level 6 in base level. We need to be level 10 in job level before we can change to a swordsman or another job. Braid, that wasn't so hard, was it? Great job. We are almost at the end of our training course. You are novice at this moment. You don't have any job for now. When you learn all basic skills and reach the job level 10, you can change your job. You can select from a number of different jobs. There are 6 basic classes. Swordsmen, who wield the long sword. Thieves with daggers. Acolytes, who support others with holy power. Magicians, who learn the power of elements. Archers with bows, and merchants who specialize in crafting and selling goods. Before you choose, you can experience them all and see which job suits you best. Behind me there are people from different guilds. They will give you manuals that allow you to experience new jobs. Queue up the chosen manual and you will be able to use some skills of the corresponding job. Try them to decide which job to choose. Alright, we will speak to this guy first. Filman, these creatures are all weak and easy to kill, but we have other training grounds where monsters are more powerful and aggressive. If you want some challenge, I can send you there. So, would you like to give it a try? No, I want an easier life, so I prefer them being weak. This is as easy as possible. Good. Let's kill a pouring. Another pouring. Doesn't really matter. Let's go to the job instructors. So we have different job instructors here. You can see we have the swordsman, the nun, thief guild member, the merchant, and we have an archer and a mage, and over there a merchant. We are attacked by this green little fable or whatever. Alright, so which one will we try first? I'm gonna go for the swordsman last. Alright, I think we will kill that one too. Alright, we will we will speak to the mage first. What can I help you? Mage, what can I help you with? Tell me about mages, thank you. Mage. Mages use various spells to protect their guild and friends. They can curse enemies using the power of the elements. They can equip only staffs and books, because they are too delicate to carry heavy weapons. But they cover this weakness with their remarkable magic skills. That is why many people want to be mages. Every guild needs mages if it wants to have power and honor. This is one of the reasons why mages are popular in any part of your guild. Why don't you become a mage? Later on, mages can become wizards or sages. Do you want to get our manual to try out the mage skills? Yes, I do. Here's the mage manual. I will take other job manuals from you. Next. After equipping a manual, use the skills that will appear in your skill window. We need to kill that thing. Alright, let's equip something. The mage manual, the gear. Alright, we've equipped again. Without the weapons we suck. As you saw, we couldn't even kill that thing. You can see the character from behind, but the one in the middle doesn't have a behind sprite. The others do. Alright. So we need to speak to the mage again to get the quest. First I will kill that thing. One hit with a knife and it was dead. Speak to the mage. What can I help you with? Give me a quest. Quest. What task would be best for you? Care to kill some lunatics with firebolt skills? With a firebolt skill? Yes. Battle basics from the mage. You can check its contents in the quest info window. I hate when they attack me when I'm speaking to someone. Alright. Skill. And then in Miss Glennis we have the skills here, Firebolt. Let's move this. Firebolt. There. Firewall. So, Firebolt. Max level 10, skill form offensive, property fire, target enemy. Description. Summons balls of pure flame to attack the enemy. Bearing changes in damage due to elemental properties. Each bolt inflicts an amount of damage equal to the caster's magic. Alright. Firewall. Max level 10, skill requirement, sight 1, fireball 5. Skill form active, property fire. Description creates a wall of flame that deters enemies and deals damage to them. Let's kill that guy. Alright, increase SP recovery, a passive ability. Max level 10. Description enhances natural skill points recovery. The skill points recovery. Wait a second, I need to kill that thing. The skill points recovery rate bonus depends on the character. Let's kill that one. Character's max skill points increases the efficiency of skill points recovering items by 2% per skill level. Cold Bolt, max level 10. Property water, skill form offensive, target enemy. Description, summons balls of frigid ice to strike an enemy. Varying changes in damage due to elemental properties. Each bolt inflicts an amount of damage equal to the caster's magic. Alright. Let's move it to F3 then. So, do we have a quest? The quest. Test the firebolt skill by hunting lunatics. And what is a lunatic? That is a lunatic. Alright. F1. We used Firebolt. Seems they are harder to kill than I thought. Fuck, we died. Yeah, didn't like mages. I think they suck. But yeah. We've finished the quest. Let's speak to her again. Can I help you with? Give me a quest. We have to hunt lunatics and bring me 5 clovers. Alright, I need to kill more of them. Oh, it died immediately there. You have tried that one already. Fuck, I'm attacked from many now. Heal myself just now. Fuck this guy. Fuck. Mage is no good in the start at least. Get the stuff here and try again. So the firewall didn't work because I tried. No, it didn't work. But we can try the this fort. We need more points to do it, I see. Do the ice attack. Alright, that worked well. We need to use some healing potions. We don't even need to use the magic to kill these. I think we are more effective using the knife actually. That's what we will do. I die faster, and I don't risk dying. Good, we're done there. I wonder if we're done with the quest or not. Fuck this guy. Cancel. Need to go and speak with that braid guy. He will give us full health and full hit skill points too. Stay a bit longer, thank you. We got full hit points now. So let's speak to that guy. Maybe we'll check the item, the quest I meant. We killed 5 already, good. Let's speak to the mage. Give me a quest again to get the reward. Mage, you have done an excellent job. Do you like the mage skills? Alright, I'll give you something. Here are some butterfly wings. Please take them as a reward. Those green things are very annoying because they attack me when I'm speaking to the AI guys. Just kill them. Die in one hit though, which is good. Alright, we're done with the mage. Let's speak to the archer. What can I help you with? Tell me about archers. Archers specialize in wielding bows. They have many powerful skills. Archers are good at attacking from a long range and keeping enemies from approaching their party members. However, archers are not very robust, so they have to keep their distance from enemies. Archers are attentive and have very sharp eyes, so once they are ready to attack, they can kill enemies before the latter even notice. Later on, an archer can become a hunter. Also, a male archer can choose the bard profession, while a female archer can be a dancer. We want to get our manual and try out some archer skills. Yes, I do. Here is the archer manual. Please study it. I will take other job manuals from you. After equipping a manual, use the skills that will appear in your skill window. Yeah. So we need to equip the weapon fast. So, and Alt S for Alt skill, then we have no new skills currently. We need to go to the Alt E first and equip the Archer manual. Now we have the skills. Kill that one. So we have improved concentration, max level 10, skill requirement vultures I1, skill form supportive. So we had to kill a pouring there. Alright. I don't like when the enemies so show up like that. Anyway, Vultures I1, skill from supportive description. Increase dexterity and agility for a set duration, and as well as detect hidden enemies. So this skill is pass supportive. It's called improve concentration. It increases our dexterity and our agility for a set duration, as well as detect hidden enemies. We have a passive skill too. We need to kill that green thing. Let's kill that thing. Right, so this one, passive description increases dexterity, alright. Let's close this window. So we have used it. Should have more dexterity now. Maybe it helps in avoiding enemy attacks and other stuff. Yeah, there were no missions they could give us, I think. No. Fortunately not. We can fight like this for a while. See how it benefits us, having increased dexterity and agility. So done. Let's heal up. So we have increased dexterity and the agility now. It seems to make the character avoid being hit more often and increase the speed of attacks, maybe. We took that down too. Alright, so we're done here. Let's kill those green stuff. Fable. Is the name Fabre? Kill it. Alright. done with that profession. Let's speak to the thief, maybe. Thief guild member, how can I help you? Tell me about thieves. Thieves are experts at using dagger class weapons. Strike quickly and easily evade attacks from their enemies. Thieves can learn skills that allow them to hide their Thieves can learn skills that allow them to hide from their enemies or steal items from monsters. They are also feared for their use of poison that slowly weakens the target. In Jeopardy, or when thieves don't want to reveal themselves, they can use the hidden skill to hide themselves underground. Thieves can change the job to assassins or rogues. I can give you the manual with some thief skills. Would you like to try them out? Not interested. Interest currently. Am I sure? Okay, as you wish. Choosing the right job is very important. Just talk to me whenever you want to experience thief skills. Fucking assholes. I don't want to be a thief yet. Because they require me to kill some dangerous creatures. So let's speak to the nun instead. What can I do for you? Who are acolytes? Acolytes worship the god. They sacrifice themselves to help others according to the teachings of their god. Acolytes in the world of Ragnarok use supportive skills to make combat easier. It is essential to have an acolyte in a party. You can upgrade the job to a priest or a monk. I can give you the manual with some acolyte skills. Would you like to try them out? Yes, please. Here go, I'll take other job manuals then. After keeping a manual, use skills that will appear in your skill window. Let's re-equip everything. Alright, and the skills. So you have heal. So the text, max level 10. Skill requirement, fate 10. Demon's Bane, skill requirement, fate 10, Demon Bane 5, skill form recovery. Target player. Description, restore a target. Description, restore a targeted player's hit points, caster's base level and intellect affect the amount of hit points recovery. Hit points recovered by heal. Blessing. Max level 10, skill requirement, divine protection 5, skill form supportive, target player. Description, increases targeted player's dexterity, intellect and strength for blessing's duration. Can also cancel abnormal statuses from curse and stone curse. And we have a supportive ability, increase agility. Description, increase the targeted character's movement and attack speeds for the duration of the skill. Drains a little hit points from the caster after each cast. Alright. So we'll add these to the menu. And close the window. So we did heal ourselves there. Thank you. clearly stronger now. Go too well doing the magics there. I'm done with being an acolyte or nun or whatever. Let's try something else. We will try the swordsman maybe. Or something. Wait a second. Try the swordsman. Can I help you? Yes, you can. Tell me about the swordsman. Literally, a swordsman is the one who is specialized in wielding swords. Swordsmen can also choose to use spears, but I must say it's a rare case. Swordsmen have great physical strength, so they can equip heavy armor and weapons. Most weapon types, except for bows and rods, are equipable by the swordsman class. The only weakness of the swordsman class is that they cannot use magic spells. However, it's compensated by using elemental weapons. The merit of being a swordsman is the enormous amount of hit points. You can bear damage from your enemy with ease. Furthermore, once you learn your strong attack skills, there is no one who can beat swordsman in a melee fight. Ragnarök Online, swordsmen take tank positions to protect weaker classes from being attacked or hurt. Swordsman is ideal for the party leader role. Fuck that guy. I need to exit this. Cancel. Fuck you. Can I help you? Yes. Tell me about the swordsman. In Ragnarök Online, swordsmen take the tank position. Yeah, I read that. Swordsmen can advance into knights or crusaders, their second class professions. If you are interested in swordsmen, I'll offer you this manual. Do you want to try out our skills? Yes, I'll try the swordsman skills. Here's the manual of swordsmen, and I'll take manuals of other jobs if you have them. Alright. After keeping a manual, use the job, blah 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 blah. Alright, we're done here. So, Alt-E. Let's re-equip everything. So, we're done with that. Let's kill that thing. Alt S for alt skill, then we will go here. Add this to the skill menu here. We'll also add first aid. Right, we're done. Let's take a look at the skills again. Miss Glanis. So, bash, max level 10, skill from offensive, target enemy. Description. Hits an enemy with crushing force. If the fatal blow of skill is learned, Description. Hits an enemy with crushing force. If the fatal blow skill is learned, bash will have an added stun effect at level 5 or and higher. And we have Magnum Break. Requirement bash 5, skill from offensive. Property fire. Description. Drains a small amount of the caster's hit points to inflict fire property AoE damage on enemies in the caster's vicinity and force them backwards for 10 sec. After that, the caster's weapon will receive a... Fuck that guy. Fuck all those. Alright. Provoke. we were on Magnum Break. Magnum Break. Drains a small amount of the caster hit points to inflict fire property area of effect. Area of AoE damage on enemies in the caster's vicinity and force them backwards. For 10 sec, after that, the caster's weapon will receive a 20% fire property strength enhancement. And we have provoke, max level 10, skill form supportive, target enemy. Okay, the description, and enrages the target to decrease its defense while increasing its attack strength. In effect against the undead, alright. So I made that less defensive then, I see. That was bash. This would be a quest to be given from this girl. Fuck that idiot. Cancel and kill these guys. Alright, speak to her now. Can I help you? Yes, you can. Give me a quest. So you want a quest? Let me see. Then you can hunt some pickies around here. Battle basics from the Swordsman Guildsman. You can check its contents in the quest info window. Use the bash skill from the Swordsman manual. Pick is an easy mob for you now, but you can find them only on difficult training grounds. Should I move you to the difficult training ground now, please? Yes. So, we're in the difficult area now. Test the bash skill while hunting pickies. This is some type of frog. So what is a picky? That's a willow. I need to kill them when I'm a thief. Picky. those things. Ruda frog. What is this? Something else. Need to find something that is called a picky. Picket. What is that? Lunatic. That's some kind of bee. Let's move on to this bridge. Kill all the Fabres. Yeah. Kills something that is called a picket. Not willows. Drops. Ah, so they drop better stuff, these guys. Lunatic there. Rusty Willow. Here are the pickets. That's a fusky, I see. Spores. We just need to find something that is called a picket. Fuck, I died. I forgot to look at the health. You are base level 9 and job level 5. Let's get full health from this guy. Alright, let's speak to this guy. I want a real challenge, thank you. So we're here again. Need to find something called a picket. Now we just need to kill these monsters. Right, that was easy, but I don't know where to find that stuff. Basic quest. Picky. Wonder where they are. Put a frog. Let's check the quest again. Test the bear skill while hunting pickies. Kill 2 pickies. I don't even know what that is. Must have managed to kill one of them in the past, but kill a lot of different beasts when I play with other character. Thank you. That's a piggy. Let's kill it. We need another one of those. They are kinda rare. Some small little birds there. We need to find. And I need to use the bash attack on it too. Alright, we need to find one of those piggies. Here is a piggy, great. I failed to use the skill on it, I think. I almost used it on it. Yes, now I succeeded. Fuck, I died! I failed to have a look at the health. Anyway, I think I'm done. Let's kill the green things for speaking to that girl again. Can I help you? Yes, you can. Give me a quest. Job level up, we are base level 10 and job level 7. Great, you're good enough to become a swordsman. I'll give you some points as a reward. Good. Right. So you're only level 7. Need to become better at having control over my own health. Let's go and kill some monsters. Let's start with these guys. Go here and kill some stronger monsters, I think. Kill this lunatic first. And that poor one could be killed as well. We got some stuff here. Could pick up. Kill that green fabre again. Ourselves. Killed another pouring there. Kill this Fabre again. Fabre again. Let's go kill that one too. Just using basic attacks because I didn't know any better. I'm done here. So things. All right. Seems to be some glitch. I can't use the special attacks. So let's go back now. Maybe we'll level up before we go back. The Fabre needs to die. The stuff they dropped and go down here. Seems still to be fighting the easier enemies, so we'll need to go to that guy and ask for him to transport us to a harder area. You're level 11 now in base level and job level 7. Kill that thing first and speak to Fearman again. I want a real challenge, thank you. Let's kill that thing. And that one too. Alright, we have some harder enemies to kill now. Can't seem to use the attack. Special attack. Sucks. Let's kill some frogs. We managed to kill them pretty easily. Picky there. Killed it in one hit. I failed to use the actual skills. Fuck, I was too slow at reaching for the potion. I guess we will need to go back to that place. Alright, I want a challenge. And I also want to save the game. We don't have to go back all the time. Stay a little longer. Ah, now I can use the skills again. I managed to hurt that frog when I did that attack. Alright. Good. Now they work again. Special skills. Need to heal myself. Move over the bridge. Easily killed with that attack. Kill a pick and run hit. Took two hits this time. Let's heal ourselves. Right. frogs. We've gone up a level. Our job level is now level 8. Attack one of these this time. Special attack doesn't work again. We died, what the fuck. Probably need to go back now because it didn't save. Monsters there. Let's go over the bridge to the more dangerous monsters. Let's kill that little Faber or whatever. Let's kill this frog too. Good, it's dead. That pouring is dead too. Don't see why not to kill them when I'm already nearby. Alright, let's heal up. Kill that Faber. Alright, let's just kill frogs, I guess. Let's heal up. Can't use the special attack now. Seems to be bugs sometimes preventing that. He died again, what the fuck, that frog attacked me. Even though I haven't clicked on it. Kill these things. Alright, so we're back here. Let's heal ourselves up. Try to use an attack there, but... Alright, it doesn't work for some reason. Couldn't win. What the fuck? Health points weren't even zero. Alright, we are at the battleground here. And we still need to level up some before we can take on more difficult monsters. Let's speak to this guy again. And to this guy. Alright, so we're here now. Right. Now the special attacks work again. So we can continue. It's boring to grind. So, we took that out with the special attack there. Let's heal ourselves. Take out these things. Don't like fighting animals you can't see. Maybe I couldn't use the skills because I had no skill points. Might be because of that. Right, so easily took care of that thing there, the feather. We need to heal up. We were almost dead. So I'm level 12 now in base level. I just recently leveled up. Level 8 in job level. We need to be level 10 in job level. Too late clicking on the potion there. Sucked. Fuck that guy. Another Faber. So, frogs were taken out quite easily there. Thank you. need to heal ourselves again, I see that. To F4. We'll do that. Fuck this green things. I want a challenge. So, we are soon level 10. I won't finish the entire novice section, but I will finish the level 10 thing. We can leave this place at least. Slow at changing between the F1 and F4 buttons. Return to game. Return to last save point, thank you. What the fuck? Could I die again? Against the frog. I was too slow at looking at the health bar. Hate when I do that mistake. Let's kill that green thing first before speaking to anyone. Alright, let's speak to him. Right, so I have full health and full skill point too. I hate these green little things, the fabers. It's annoying when they attack all the time. are soon job level 9. Try this. I'll try again with this. Fuck. He got help from that little fucker. We're back here. I will avoid those spores. Can't defeat them. Alright, we're done here. Let's move to the other side. Thank you. And we got a level. We earned a level. We leveled up. So we have job level 9 now. Need to heal ourselves. So go and get the other quest for the thief now. They need to kill that thing first, maybe. A lot of players now. Alright, so we're done here. Let's speak to the merchant soon. Need to kill these things first. Alright, let's speak to the merchant. We have stuff to sell. Fly wing. An enchanted fly's wing that instantly sends its user to a random spot when evade in the air. Well, I don't want to sell that. Green herb. Valuable medicinal. Valuable medicinal herb which counteracts the effects of poison could be used. Too many of them here. Feather of birds. Go back to the other part. An easier life for now. I need them to not attack me when I'm speaking to that person. I need to speak to this guy too. Peace. Kill the favors. Alright, now let's speak to this person. So, sticky webfoot. A webbed foot cut from a monster's hind leg. A webbed foot cut from a monster's hind leg. Sticky mucus. Very sticky liquid. Let's sell it to you. Sticky mucus. Very sticky liquid. Sell all of it. Another one there. It will probably attack soon. Let's sell some more stuff. Wand. An unknown item that requires appraisal. It can be identified by using a magnifier. Don't want to sell it then. Feather. A feather that boasts full lustrous barbs used. Fuck, I need to move closer to the TV. Feather that boasts full lustrous barbs used for making clothes of the highest quality. Don't need that. Don't need a mace either. Sell them. Novice fly wing. A knife, yes, we can sell it to you. Maybe not. We might need it for one of the other classes. Fluff. Clump of monster fur that can be used to make threads of fabric. Let's sell it. Yellow pea. Small crystallization created by some monsters. Sell it to you. Carrot, an orange root that is supposedly good for your vision, despite the beta carotene. Kids don't care. I don't want to sell that, it gave health. Yes, I need to sell. Fucking assholes. Let's speak to this guy again. Right, so we're done there. Shell. A hard shell that used to protect the monster. Let's sell that one. Hate when I miss. I need to click on the OK button. Feather. Feather that boasts full lustrous barbs used for making clothes, yeah. Sell that one too. Mace, let's sell it. Alright, sell time. Oh, that's a battle tattered minion. suit, novice cutter, April, novice flying. Alright, I don't have much more to sell now. Alright, so we are Yab level 9 and base level 12. I need to speak to that other profession now. We have spoken to the nun, we have the thief left and the merchant, I see. We'll start with the merchant then. What can I help you with? Tell me about merchants. Merchants, to put it simply, we sell goods and make money. That's what it's all about. We have our special skills for earning more money. We can buy goods at a lower price and sell items at a higher one. Oh fuck, I should have sold them as a merchant. I forgot about that. Also, merchants can use carts to store more items. A merchant can become a blacksmith or an alchemist. Do we want to get our manual and practice some merchant skills? Yes. Here is the merchant manual. Please study it. I will take other job manuals from you. And Alt E. So we get the weapons back. Thank you. So we're down there. Now let's kill this thing. And this one. Alright, and now let's see here. We have equipped everything. And it's the skill section. Alright, so we have Mammonite. Max level 10, skill from offensive, target enemy. Description, inflicts surprising damage to a target by spending an amount of Cine determined by the level of skill that is cast. Alright. And then we have discount, which is a passive ability. Description, decreases the prices of items sold by NPC's shops. And overcharge. Description, increases the amount of Cine received for items sold to NPC shops. Fuck, I just sold everything. Alright, item appraisal. Description, identifying an unknown item, making it available for use, like a scroll of identity, pretty much. Alright, we did it on that thing. Alright, equipment, simple wand, tag 15, neutralized, acolyte, mage, I see, and novice. I need to change to a merchant now. Give me a quest. Merchant, huh, quest, what should I give you? Okay, then bring me 300 Cine by selling some of your items to another merchant. Use overcharge and discount skills from the manual. I'll wait for you here, good luck. Let's sell some more stuff. Fluff can be sold. The rod could also be sold. Maybe I should have it still. merchant again. Next. Make quest. Excellent! Cine is Ragnarok's in-game money. You can make Cine by selling loot. You also have a great attacking skill powered by Cine. It's called Mammonite. We basically use a bag of money to strike the enemy. Death by Cine. And we earned some experience there. Our base level went up to level 13 and we have job level 9 now. The merchant says, by the way, you've done an excellent job, so I should give you something. What would it be? Right, what about some frackens? You can use them for refining weapons. Alright. Alright, only the thief left then. So let's try the thief. Thief Guildmaster, how can I help you? Tell me about thieves. Thieves are experts at using dagger class weapons. They strike quickly and easily evade attacks. Thieves are experts at using dagger class weapons. They strike quickly and easily evade attacks from their enemies. Thieves can learn skills. Thieves can learn skills that allow them to hide from their enemies or steal items from monsters. They are also feared for their use of poison that slowly weakens the target. In jeopardy, or when thieves don't want to reveal themselves, they can use the hiding skill to hide themselves underground. Thieves can change their job to assassins or rogues. I can give you the manual with some thief skills. Would you like to try them out? Yes. Here's our manual. We take other class manuals, alright. After keeping a manual, blah blah blah. Let's kill this guy. We need to equip our weapon, of course. And our armors. Alright, we're done. I want to equip that book too. It doesn't seem like I can. Weird. Guidebook that enables one to experience the basic thief skills. That doesn't seem like I can keep it. Speak to this guy again. I can't equip the fucking book. I don't have a book there. Open fuck this. I'll need to exit probably. Fuck that. I managed to exit the game, which wasn't the plan, but, well, I'm back now. Fuck, and now I managed to click that button there. So I can't use the fucking book, what the fuck? Let's see, what can I do for you? Just click next. Alt E. Hate of these things always attack when I'm busy doing stuff. So, let me try the thief now. Assholes. can't equip it for some reason. I ran away. Let's kill these fabulous. Use the first aid there. For some reason I can't equip that fucking book thief manual, and without it I can't get the thief skills. I don't know what the problem is. F5. Nothing happens. Really can't use it. Very annoying. Of course that thing is attacking me now. So, and some of the menu seems to be gone. Alright, I don't like those green little fabbers there. They are very aggressive. Anyway, we were going to change our job, but it didn't work. I couldn't equip the the book of the thief manual. Let's try now. Doesn't seem to work for some reason. Very annoying. So the game certainly has some bugs. I mean, it worked in a, with a different character, but now for some reason I can't use the book. Nothing happens when I double click. So it sucks. Tell me about the swordsman. Yeah, let's just skip all that. And change to swordsman again. No, we can't equip the book for some reason. Let's kill that insect. Alright, we are not using any weapons. We need to re-equip the character. No manual equipped, and still we can't equip it for some reason. Sucks. So I need to restart everything because it doesn't work. I get experience if I finish all the quests, but I can't equip the book, and without the book I can't get the actual skills of the thief, so I won't be able to finish the quest. I mean, I can't kill those three monsters if I can't use the thief abilities. I will be too weak, I guess. Seal up. So I don't know what to do. Can't discard it either. What the fuck? So we are base level level 13 and job level 9. We could of course finish it by just killing monsters too. But without the books we can't equip the skills, we won't have any special skills, which means killing monsters will take more time. impossible to keep the books for some reason. Refuses to be equipped, so I can't equip the thief manual. Sucks. Otherwise, I could have gotten a job. Maybe I can still get the job or quest. Thief guildmaster, a quest, huh? What will be good for you? I know. Go kill some willows, which is some tree. As the evidence, please bring me 5 tree roots they drop when you kill the willows. If you equip the thief manual, you can use the double attack and flee skills. These are our main features. Good. But I can't equip the manual for some reason. Fuck, I managed to remove the quest. I clicked the wrong option there. Give me a quest again. What the fuck? Next. Give me a quest. Okay. I still have the quest, but not according to this screen. There you are. We have it here. Text. The double attack and flee skills. Test the double attack and flee skills while hunting 5 willows. They can't test them without being able to equip the books. It's impossible to finish the quest. You could still kill the willows, but can't test 2 skills. So fucking stupid. Game certainly has bugs. And you can't equip the fucking book to get the skills. I can still kill them. But even if you can kill them, that's not enough. Oh, I might need to pick up that tree root there. Kill this green Fabres for the attack. I don't like being attacked by them when I'm fighting something else. So we will kill those Fabres there and then we will attack this willow. another willow there. We'll go attack and kill it. I attacked the wrong thing there. Alright, we need to heal up. Kill another willow, but we will kill that green fabre there first. Fuck that fabre. Alright, we're done there. Alright, let's kill that willow now. Fuck, I managed to attack some poor one there. And we leveled up to base level 14. That's good. Let's check the quest. How many do I have? I've killed 5, so it's fine, but I haven't used the attacks. We'll still go back now. To the quest giver, the thief guild master. Alright, we'll speak to the guild master again. How can I help you? Tell me about the thieves now. Give me a quest. Yes, and we finished the quest. Awesome, we almost leveled up to level 10. So we just need to kill some more monsters, and then we can move on. But for now, we need to kill some monsters. Let's kill this willow here. And that fabre there. Let's kill a pouring. I managed to click on it for some reason. Let's kill that willow. And let's move to the other side of the bridge. Like how you can like move them like this, move the angle around. See from different angles. Let's kill that frog. Whew, I almost died. Let's heal up. They die in like 2 hits, it's no problem. Let's pick up all this stuff that they dropped. We'll have to sell them later. Alright, now let's go kill some fabbers there. And then kill some willows. I never managed to kill those swamp things, the spores, or whatever. Whatever they are known as. We will kill them later. Let's kill this willow here. Let's heal up. Kill that Fabre. Kill one of these. Alright. We had to use a lot of healing potions here. They were hard to kill. Without any skills. Yes! And we killed it! And we leveled up too. So we are job level 10 and base level 15. Awesome. We are ready to go to the other area and do the quest to become a swordsman. But I will need to sell some stuff first. Let's speak with this girl, the merchant. Alright, let's sell some stuff. So, we want to sell you some of our stuff that we have gotten. We have some spawn frog eggs here. Let's sell all of them. And then we have some fine grained trunk there. Three trunk of wood with an excellent grain. Let's sell them too. We have some barren trunk. Let's sell all of them. So, I'm gonna speak to her again. And we will sell some more stuff. Unfortunately, we can only sell three things at once. So we have a webbed foot cut from a monster's hind leg. Sell that. There is no other use for it. We have some resin, a vicious plant substance used in the production of certain types of goods. Let's sell it to FOP. Small crystallization created by some monsters. Yes, it will be sold. Actually, I should probably be a merchant when I sell stuff. I will earn more money then. We will become a merchant again. Alright, I did a mistake there. I should have sold everything when accepting the temporary merchant role. So if you are in this place, make sure to be the merchant when you sell stuff. Let's kill this guy. So I need to equip my stuff again. Otherwise I suck. Alright, let's speak to her and sell more stuff now that I'm a merchant for the time being. Some roots from trees can be used as medicine. Tree root. But most of them are fibrous enough to be used as rope. Let's see. Let's sell the tree roots. Green herb. Valuable medical herb which counteracts the effects of poison. That could be actually good, but let's just sell everything. Fluff. A clump of monster fur that can be used to make threads and fabric. Let's sell it here. I wonder if the anime Rise of the Shield Hero was inspired by this game. I think so, because it's very much the same in how you sell stuff after killing monsters and such. Alright. Prakon. A metal that can be used to strengthen and upgrade weapons. That could be good to keep. Flower. Plant with three heart-shaped leaves that is plentiful in meadows. Let's sell. Actually, I will sell the Prakon as well. I don't think I have any use for it. I will keep the milk. I can heal with it. We have a rod. Simple magic wand. Job's mage. Let's keep it. I believe the carrot can also heal and the empty bottle could be used for something. So we have some other stuff like the novice cutter here. Don't really need the novice cutter anymore. Let's sell them. Tattered novice ninja suit. Could sell as well. Novice butterfly wing. An enchanted butterfly's wing that can instantly send its user to their save point. I think I will keep that. Sell the knife. And the cotton shirt. We could keep it, by the way. We don't know if we will get anything new in a while. Yes, I will not be able to use the novice stuff when I become a swordsman. So I might have the cotton shirt as the only shirt for a while. It's better than nothing. Alright, and we're done here. I've sold everything, so cancel. And let's exit that screen. And we are good to go here. We need to speak to this guy now. Braid. Have you tried new skills for... Braid, have you tried new skills from manuals? If you want to learn more about jobs, talk to the people behind me. I think you've learned enough. Do you want to officially complete your training and go to town? I want to go to town. Looks like you're ready. I guess you've made up your mind, huh? Well, where do you want to go? Frontera, Morrockhaven. Actually, I don't want... Let's cancel that. Yeah, let's not hurry. Meet up with the people from each guild. Right, and this other guy. So I can choose different cities and teleport to them if I can talk to Braid here. But I believe if I talk to one of the guys representing each job, then they will take me to a specific place for that specific job. So I will speak to the swordsman or knight here. I believe it's a swordsman, because we want to become a swordsman. These creatures are stronger than others. We have training grounds where monsters are less powerful and aggressive. No, I don't want to go there. Never mind, I'm good here. Right, let's speak to the swordsman. Can I help you? Tell me about swordsman. I want to be a swordsman. Swordsman Guildsman, do you really want to change your job to Swordsman? If you've decided, I'll send you to the Swordsman Guild immediately. Yes, thank you. Swordsman Guildsman, don't you increase your job level, of course. She said, don't forget to increase your job level, of course. Do you want to stop the training now and go to the Swordsman Guild? Yes, send me there right away. I close your training ground and send you to the Swordsman Guild. Good. Now we're here. So we have a swordsman here that we will speak to. Swordsman, welcome to the Swordsman Association. So, what business brings you to us? Job change. Swordsman. So, you wish to become a proud swordsman. by all means, please sign up. Sign up, yes. Swordsman, ah, yes. Your application will be reviewed as soon as possible. If you have already met the requirements, you can take an interview right now. Would you like to? Yes. Swordsman, good, good. Now, let's see. You still haven't learned all of the basic skills. You need to do that before you can become a swordsman. Check the requirements for job change again. Come back when you are ready. Alright, I need to go to skills. Then I have skill points 9 because I've reached level... over level 10 in Diablo. So we need to give all the skills to basic skills here. You see the basic skills, max level 9. Enables the use of basic skills level 1. Enables emotions level 2. And opens additional emotion icons level 3. Wait a second. Level 1 enables trading. Allows trading with other characters. Level 2 enables emotions. Alt plus 0 to 9. Citra L plus 1. Citra, etc. Alt plus L opens additional emotion icons. Right. And then level 3 enables sitting. Sitting doubles hit points, skill points, recovery rate. Press the insert key or type slash sit. Level 4 enables chat room creation. Click Ctrl C to create a chat room. Level 5 enables joining a party. Your character can join a party. Level 6 enables use of Kafra storage. Loves use of Kafra storage. Level 7 enables organizing a party. Create a party by typing organize slash organize party party name. Set party options in the party window. Alt plus C. Level 9 enables class change. Your character can change their class, and we will click apply. Once used, skill points cannot be reallocated. Continue. Yes. So now we are ready. Let's speak to the swordsman again. Yup, change. Swordsman, you've learned all of the basic skills but didn't take the test yet. You must first pass the exam before you can change your job to swordsman. Enter the room to the right from you so that you can take the test. Alright, let's speak to this guy first. We have Shurank here. Shurank, still wondering what to do with your future, eh? If I may be so bold, I suggest you follow the path of strength, become a swordsman. If you wish to stake your life on the way of the sword, speak to the Swordsman Association representative to the left. Yes, I've already done that. Shurank, whatever you do, I hope that you live out your life without any regrets. And if you do happen to become a swordsman, come back to me. Sure. Let's speak to this guy now. So we have some testful staff here. Let's speak to that staff. So are you here, testful staff? So are you the one who wants to be a swordsman? All right. You look reliable. Try to relax and do your best. This course isn't too difficult. Isn't so difficult. Alright, so that was the one that gave the quest, I see. If I go down into these holes, I will fall down into a dungeon and have to fight some monster to get up here again. So if I fall down, I will have to fight some monsters and then I will find a way up, so I start here again. So it's a test to get to the other side without falling down. I already know how to do it now. I didn't in the past. The last time I did this, I've done it once before. Fuck! I managed to mess up, but this happens when you mess up. Let's heal. I don't like when I don't have everything equipped. So let's, it's also, this test is a time test. You have 10 minutes to reach the other side. And if you die, you lose. And if you fail to reach the other side in 10 minutes, you will also lose. So. We'll take it very... That was close. You will be careful not to fall down. Don't want to fall down to that dungeon and have to do everything again. If we fall down now, for example, we will have to restart from the beginning of the test. There are like 3 or 4 parts. We'll take it careful. And we finished the first part. Good. We didn't need to speak to those guys. We already know what they would do. Alright, let's be careful and not move the mouse too far from the character, far away from the character. Because if we fall down, we will have to restart. But I believe we will start before this part just started. So we will be very careful here, not to fall down into the dungeon. Same here. Seems to go pretty well, but you never know, you may fuck up and have to restart it. That's annoying, especially since it's on time. And we finished that part, so we are done with 2 out of 3. Let's speak to the staff. Do a surrender. No, I don't. This is the second checkpoint. Cheer up. Alright, let's go into that point there. Checkpoint. Doesn't matter if we go down into these squares, but we can't fall down into the black ones without having to restart and fight our way up. So we'll have to be careful here. What happened? We were automatically forced into some dungeon there. To kill some monsters. We don't have any class skills, so we can only use the basic attack to kill that insect. We went up a level there. We are level 16 now, in base level. We killed all those monsters. Ignore the stuff that they dropped, but that doesn't matter really. You're only interested in finishing the quest. Let's kill that faber there. Find our way back. I believe it's up here. Yeah, let's kill the fabers. And enter this place. We have to restart. I believe some of those green squares might be dangerous, so we will try to avoid them this time. Jesus Christ! I thought there was a trap there. Right, let's take it very careful here. You don't want to fall down into a dungeon again. Move this way and straight forward and move to the side. Move to this side. is straight up there. Now we need to be careful so we don't fall down and have to redo it all again. I hate redoing stuff. And then forward. The final part is a little tricky here. Jesus Christ! I have to redo it again. He took the wrong turn. He was supposed to go straight up there, but instead he decided to be an idiot and go to the side. Now we need to remake or redo all that shit again. Let's kill some monsters. That bee and these fabbers here. Kill them all. At least we get some experience, but I still am on a timer here. I need to be done in 10 minutes. So that's not good. Let's kill this fabber. Good. But now we need to redo this again. And I can't fuck up, so I need to be careful. Holy crap, we fucked up big time there. It's almost done. I believe the first time I did this one, I managed to finish it without fucking up. But I was lucky probably at the last part. Jesus Christ! Don't want to fall down. So now we need to be careful as fuck. Thank God. We're done. I speak to this girl. So May, I sincerely congratulate you for passing the test. I've sent your test result to the job department. Please proceed to the central office. Thank you. Alright, so we're done with the Swordsman test. Let's speak to this one. Hey, you need to talk to the Swordsman in the center of the room, not me. Alright. What does this guy say now? Still wondering what to do with your future, eh? Maybe so bold, I suggest you follow the path of strength. Yeah, it just says the same thing. Let's speak to the Swordsman then. Swordsman. Welcome to the Swordsman Association. So, what business brings you to us? Job change. Ha 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 ha! Congratulations! Now you are fully qualified to be a real swordsman. I will transform you right away. Good, and we went up a level. We are now level 1 for the swordsman. We were maximum level of novice. Now we are maximum level of swordsman. So the swordsman says, once again, congratulations. I expect that you will be a good representative of the Swordsman Association. Thank you. Alright, let's equip stuff. Some of the stuff we can't equip, because it states here, jobs, novice only, so we need to sell all the stuff that are novice only. This hood, for example, is also novice only, so we can't equip it anymore. Same with these novice slippers. And we have a weapon here, I'm not sure about it. Account bound, but is it for novices only? I'm not sure. Jobs, novice jobs. Let's see if we can equip it. I don't think so. So for each job change, you will lose the ability to use specific gear that is only available for the older class that you just left behind. The novice guard shield, also for novices only, so I can't equip any of this stuff. Same with the novice false eggshell. Alright, but we have a novice adventurer's suit here, and it's for all jobs. We can still use it. Let's equip the novice adventurer's suit. We also have the cotton shirt. I believe this one is better, so we will re-equip it. And we should have a sold the knife. That wasn't good. The knife that was for all the classes. This one was only for the novice. I did a mistake. Alright. So we're done here. Let's speak to this guy now. Shurank. Ah, a comrade in arms. Allow me to introduce myself. I am Shurank. Shurank Chandler. A knight in the service of the Prontera chivalry. It concerns me deeply that the swordsmen of today may not truly understand the way of the sword, and to think that they may become knights later. Have you been training to be an expert swordsman? If so, you must learn the fundamentals, the first of which is the bash skill. Gasp. Those soft, delicate hands. You never learned how to use bash, haven't you? How do you expect to lead battles without knowing bash? Now, if you wish to become a true swordsman, you must learn the bash skill. There's no question about it. You've got to know these basics. Take this and learn to use bash. Learn to bash. So we have all of these skills now. When I click Alt S for Alt Skill, we bring up this menu, and as you can see, we have lots of cool skills. We have Provoke, for example. We can't use it yet because let's see, we are base level 16 and job level 1. We probably need a higher job level. So. This is supportive, provoke. Enrages target to increase its defense. I guess we need to give skill points to these skills in order to use them, like in Diablo 2 or other similar games. And we currently have 0 skills. We spent all the 9 skills on the basic skill. So we need to level up our jab skill in order to get more points, or level up the base skill, I'm not sure. Anyway, we need to level up to get skill points so we can give ourselves these new skills like bash, provoke, berserk, hit points recovery, fatal blow, endure, and magnum break. Alright, but we don't have the skills for that currently. Let's go into this side here and see who is here. Speak to this guy. Aaron. A swordsman, don't you think high vitality accompanied by vigorous training and unique breathing methods which enable quick hit point recovery are the greatest advantages of a swordsman? If you train very well, you will notice how fast your hit points recovers. The recovery depends on vitality. If you invest in your vitality more, the recovery amount increases accordingly. Of course, it'd be great to have a powerful attack, wouldn't it? You can either acquire a good weapon or bring up your strength to increase your power. You'll need more strength to swing good weapons easily anyway. Another important thing is your accuracy in hitting opponents. Dexterity is the key there. If you improve your dexterity, then the gap between the min and max damage will decrease. Are you bored? Or do you want me to go on? End the conversations. Thank you, I already know those basics from other games. Alright, and let's go back here. And let's go into let's speak to this guy first. Sorry guy, but I can only allow novices to enter the test hall. Yeah, I've already done the test anyway. Let's move into this place. And we ended up in a new location. Alright, let's speak to this guy. So we have red here. The only skill that's needed for a swordsman is bash, bash, bash. Only bash. No need to waste time and effort for small skills. Everything else is for cowards and chickens. Shibboleths. Shibboleths, what are you talking about? Needless to say, it is but romantic for a swordsman to stand decisively alone against all enemies. If you have a magnum break, you can do the job right. Well, it does splash damage. It does splash damage to even unsuspecting enemies wandering around. They'll all end up coming after you, but that is a risk a swordsman should be willing to take. Red, that's exactly why you're dumb, you idiot. What about the romance of the swordsman? I still remember the last time you used magnum break. You were just busy running away from all the pourings hit by that stupid skill, you weakling. All those pourings around you got hit and they tried to get back at you. Sebalis, you always keep such a trifle event in your mind for too long. I'm telling you, magnum break is the skill for a swordsman. Bash is just one of the steps towards magnum break. Red, oh man, hey, I know you heard everything. So what do you think? Which one do you think is better? One critical damage skill, bash, or the splash damage skill, magnum break? I think bash would fit my playstyle more, even though I know that magnum break is probably better for a party, so the swordsman can be a tank and take all the attacks while the other casters, etc., like the hunter and the mage attack from behind. Red, ha 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 ha, I know you'd choose it. You are a great guy. Bash is undoubtedly the best swordsman skill. Please tell that to that bonehead over there. Let me give you a bit of advice. After you achieve level 5 bash, the amount of skill points the skill consumes increases greatly. Watch out for your skill points. Yes, thank you. Alright, so we are entering the city here. I'm almost at the point where I was previously with the other character. So we have, in that version I had already spoken to everyone in this area, so I will probably do that. But now let's go into this place here, store. And let's update our weapon. So we have a weapon dealer here. Let's sell some stuff. So we have some novice stuff to sell here. Novice slippers. And the somber novice hood. And I believe that's the... let's see here. Novice main gouge. Let's sell all of those. And then we have... don't need to sell the butterfly wings, etc. I don't know if we may be able to use them somehow. We'll probably sell the mage, the rod there, after all. And then novice false eggshell. And the novice guard. Let's sell all of those. got some stuff from the monsters that I will sell as well. Fluff and a shell there. And we're done. Let's sell those things. And we have 1938 Cine. That's good. Let's see if we can buy anything. We have a knife we can buy for 50 Cine. But we need something better than a knife. It has attack 17. It's pretty bad. It's worse than our previous knife. We have another knife here. We have a cutter. More like a small sword, like a Roman sword probably. Attack 30, pretty good, but I believe the knife we had previously had like 45 or 40 in attack. Here the main gouge, 2400, that's too much. So we can get a cutter, we can also get a sword, but they suck. Attack 25. I know the other character bought a falchion, so it's 1500. Unhanded sword, attack 39. Alright, I will go for the falchion because I did that in the other playthrough, so we will buy the falchion. Then we will equip this cotton shirt and... no, we had an adventurous shirt and... Let's equip the falchion and sell the shirt as well. I don't really need it anymore. Alright, let's speak to the armor dealer. We probably won't have enough money to buy anything here. See, we can get a jacket for 200 Cine. An adventure shirt for 1000. Defense 20. Wait, 30. Let's see what we have. So, click the wrong button. I need this one up. So we have a Novice Adventurer's shirt. Defense 45. Yabs all. Right, and this Adventurer's shirt had less defense actually, but have weight 30 instead, and jobs all. We don't have enough money for it anyway. The jacket on the other hand is defense 15. I believe we already have a better one, so we won't buy anything more this time. We didn't have enough money for any of the good stuff there, so let's go back to the city. Let's see who we can speak to. Here is some guy. We have a... Let's go speak to that one. Soldier! Why am I so happy, you wanna know? Sure, why? Soldier, there's not much for us to do these days. Merchants buy items which monsters drop. You knew that, right? Yes, I do. Of course. Soldier, haha! In fact, that was actually our job. But there were more and more hunters who come in order to get paid. It was just too much to handle. We had to do work overtime every day. That was a nightmare. Anyways, the government took a smart move, making the registration system. The Office of Price Compensation only pays those who have registered. Requirements for registration are for a merchant to secure sufficient funds and to stay at one place all the time. The office gives away the registration to any merchant who fulfills these requirements. So there aren't too many people who come to us anymore. I mean, we are still busy, but that's nothing compared to how it was before. People who suffered first know how to give thanks to even the slightest comfort. Alright. See if there is anything we can check over here. Some nice statues here, but no person to speak to. bridge. And there's another bridge here we can move onto. We can't go to the other side, I see. Let's move into this place then. See if there is anything interesting inside. Nah, there were no point there. Nothing special. We will check other areas of the city. Here is a place where we can enter, but we will speak to this guy first. Kylek, don't you think telescopes are really cool? You can see here and there. We here at Islud are responsible for maintaining peace, not only on land but also at sea. That's why we have that huge telescope. It would watch over the sea constantly to prevent any serious troubles. After all, as the doctors say, prevention is better than cure. Alright, so we are at the city of Islud. Let's enter this place. Alright, we will speak to this person first. Please select a trade type, buy and sell. What does she sell then? A magnifier. Magnifying glass used for identifying equipment. I believe I bought 5 of them on the other playthroughs. We will do that. I want 5 actually. And okay. What else did she sell? Red potion. We already have like novice potions over 740. And anyone can use them, I believe. An exclusive red potion for novices. They can't use it anymore. Maybe not. Let's buy some ordinary potions then. We have 240 Sini left. Let's buy 5 of these. We don't have enough money. Right, let's buy 3. Alright, buy. And we have only 93 Sini left. Besides that, she is also selling better stuff. Now we are selling, I meant buying. So she is selling orange potions, yellow potions, green potions, concentration potions, awakening potions. What is that? Special tonic that makes you vigilant, I see. Flying, butterfly wing, trap, arrow. Alright. Can't buy anything more. Let's speak to this guy. And he is selling bullets, silver bullets, bloody cell. Shrell, branch, crimson bolt. So he seems to be selling a lot of like weapons or ammunition for weapons or whatever to a certain class, but not our class. Let's speak to this person. Hugo, don't you wish you had great items for pets you've adopted? Here are some popular items. Inquire monster taming. Order Book of Devil, Order No Recipient, Order Horror of Tribe, and Conversation. Yeah, I like pets, let's go for it. Hugo, if you want to have a wonderful bond with your pet, you should prepare something nice that would please your pet. We, members of the Pets Adopting Union, have come up with a whole bunch of groovy items. Hugo, based on what pet owners need, you can shop here without pressure. Horror of Tribe, No Recipient, Book of Devil. To get Book of Devil, you have to give me 1 old magic book and 2 horrendous mouths. To get No Recipient, you need 1 old portrait. And as for Horror of Tribe, you need 1 patriotism marks. and one Scorpion's Tail. Enjoy. So I need some stuff in order to get those books. Alright, and there is nothing over here, I guess. No. Let's exit this place. So we are done here. Here's another person that we will speak to. Please select a trade type, so it's also seller. Pet food, pet incubator, backpack, rocket glasses, yummy meat. Alright, we can get stuff for pets, but we don't have any pets, so that doesn't matter. And let's speak to this guy now. Tony. Hey, I'm Tony. I'm in charge of distributing and making bullets for gunslingers. Just how our guild likes to do things. I'm sorry if you came here to buy some bullets. I can only do business with fully fledged gunslingers. I see. And this person? Kenny. Welcome to my shop here. I provide magazines and cartridges for gunslingers. Sorry, but it doesn't look like my service would be of any use to you, adventurer. But if you happen to know any gunslingers, send them my way. You can never have too many bullets. Alright. So different class is needed there. We have someone else here. Diga. Incidentally, some monsters can detect magic before it is cast. Golem of the Desert is one of them. If you underestimate it due to its sluggish movement and try to cast magic near it, it will immediately notice what you're doing and will attack you, so watch out for Golem. Alright. Thanks for the tip there. And let's speak to this guy. We will check the sign here. Islud, the satellite sim. Islud, the satellite city. Welcome to Islud, the satellite city of Prontera. Islud was built to take partial charges from Prontera. Islud, you can become a swordsman at the Swordsman Association building. Yeah. And you can visit the arena battle ground at north of Islud. You can visit the arena battleground at north of Islud. Trips to Alberta and Bjelland, Iceland are accessible at the dock. From the city, Prontera is located at northeast and Payon is at south. Enjoy your travel. Let's speak to this guy. Smile Gal. Hello, how are you? I am Mr. Smile Supporter. I am the Mr. Smile Supporter. How may I assist you? Information on Mr. Smile, make Mr. Smile. Let's take the information. Smile Girl. To make Ragnarok an enjoyable experience, His Majesty Tristram III has opened the event. I am the one leading the Be Happy and Smile event. Smile Girl 1. I make Mr. Smile using very simple items. You don't have to feel frustrated while gathering the items. These are the items needed for the Mr. Smile mask. Smile Girl, 10 Yellowbee, 10 Fluff, and 10 Clover. I hope everyone will take this opportunity to help each other out with a smile. Right, let's speak to this guy. Saskol, the pub in Prontera is always full of people from locals to out-of-towners. Very uproarious. There is so much information and rumors you can get from people going in and out. If you listen to them carefully, you just might get lucky and get some useful information yourself. Yeah, thanks for the information. And here we have another player. Merchant, probably. Here we have an NPC. We will speak to her. Kafra employee. Welcome to the Kafra Corporation. The Kafra services are always on your side. How may I assist you? So I want to save, I could use the storage, use teleport service, rent a pushcart. Let's save. Kafra employee, your respawn point has been saved in the city of Islud. Thank you for using the Kafra service. Yeah. And here's another NPC, let's speak to that guy. Islud guide, hey, welcome to the new town, Islud. I'm the civil service agent on Islud guide duty. To ask me where everything is. So ask me where everything is. Right. So receive guide of the city. Delete all indicators on the minimap. Listen to notices. Or you can leave. Let's receive the guide of city. Yes. So, Islud guide, what do you want to know? Choose wanna leave indicators on the minimap. Next. So we can get, I took the wrong option, but now we can get info on the Swordsman Guild, Swordsman Association, Arena and the docks. Let's go get the information on the Swordsman Guild. Even though I probably already know that. You wanna be a Swordsman? I am a Swordsman. Swordsman Association. The Swordsman Association is at the East End. They do all the Swordsman business there. Probably where came from there. Arena. Oh, excuse me. The Arena, Islud's landmark, is at the North End, or 12 o'clock clockwise. My brother works there, and he says it's not open yet. You won't find anything interesting. Alright, docks then. You can go to Alberta or Biela, Iceland via the docks. Located on the north east edge of town. Between 1 or 2 o'clock. Clockwise. Weapon shop. Weapon shop is northeast of town, you can't miss it, yeah, I was there already. And the tool shop. Tool shop is northeast of town, it's easy to find, yeah, I was there too. Cancel. So that guy was there for information. There are two ways here. We can go this way to reach an area outside of the city where we can fight monsters, or we can go this way to find the ships. Go here first. So we are now outside. We have a ship there and a guy here. We will speak to him first. Man, you can really call this place an airport. It's far too small. Can you really call this place an airport? It's far too small. Wouldn't you agree? Still, I kind of enjoy sitting around here. Alright. And this girl here. Airship staff, welcome. Would you like to board the airship and depart or on the flight to Juno in the Schwarzwald Republic? Schwarzwald Republic. Hard to pronounce that and hard to read. I'm a bit away from the screen. Using the 42-thumbs TV as the screen. Alright, board the airship to Juno. No, thank you. So this is the airship. Reminds me of the Zeppelins in World of Warcraft. Let's go back to the city. Let's take a look at the area outside of the city. Need to go into this bridge, onto this bridge here. Alright, then let's speak to this girl. Bonnie, Islud welcomes you. Islud is the satellite city of Prontera, capital of the kingdom of Rune-Midgard. Islud is very important, not only because of the Swordsman Association resides here at Islud. Not only because the Swordsman Association resides here at Islud, but also because we guard and secure our coastline. Also, this bridge might look weak and all, but it's actually a state-of-the-art structure built with the most sophisticated and advanced technology the world has ever seen. No matter how strong storms may be, how many people may stand on it, this bridge will never collapse. You could test it if you like. Please enjoy your visit here at Islud. Yes, thank you. Let's move out. And we're at the outskirts of the city of Islud. This is the outside area. You can zoom in. Like this, of course. We have a pouring here. Let's kill it. This is the sword. So we look like this now. Zoomed in, we look like this. And zoomed out, looks better. Let's pick this up. Got some stuff there. Attack some more pourings. So we have an outer area here with enemies, wild animals. Mostly pourings at the start. They are very weak, of course. Alright. I'm not gonna play with this character more anymore because we have the other character where I had gotten a friend a few days ago. I don't know. That person might have played for 3 days now or more. So he must be. It's a guy probably, but the character is a female, so we'll say Shree. Shree probably is at a much higher level now than she was 3 days ago or something. Let's kill this thing too. So that means she might be too good to be in my party, but still, it's a veteran player. I could use advice from her. She helped me in the past. Fuck, I forgot to check my health. Resurrecting the save point. Thank you. Did I lose my equipment by dying? Not sure. Items. No, we still have our equipment. Good. Alright, so we're respawned here. There seems to be some more guys that I haven't seen before. Let's speak to them. I forgot to speak to these guys. Speak to this guy first. Arena fighter, do you want to take a challenge in the new player versus player mode? Move to the waiting room. Leave council. I'm not interested in fighting others. That's a player, the merchant there. Speak to this guy. Please select a trade type. So another trader sells meat. Alright, a chunk of meat that's been cooked to near perfection. Restores 70 to 100 hit points. We almost have no health, by the way. Let's use the first aid. It will cost us some skill points to use. We aren't healing up a lot either. Alright, that's all we could do. We could use the potion though. We can still use the novice potions, alright. I want to try and sit down on the bench. So, slash sit. He is actually sitting down. Not the way I thought he would. So now it looks better. sitting on the bench. Like how the sprite changes like that. Based on how you move the camera. Cancel, let's speak to this girl. She's also selling something. Apples, bananas, carrots and potato. Alright, all of them heal health. Let's see here. We needed to type the same thing again, slash it, in order to get back on our feet so we could move. Alright, we're done here. And this is it for now. I need to just go back to the initial place, the initial shop here. Because I ended the other recording there. Fuck, I went inside the shop. That wasn't intended. Alright, so we are here. So this is it for now. I will continue this campaign later as the other character. So this is how he looks now. He has a falchion and he has the novice adventurer suit. The other character might actually use the other suit because I think I sold the novice adventurer suit, which was stupid. I thought it wasn't usable for anyone else. 45 defense. So that sucks if it's... Unfortunately, we won't have it with the other character. Alright. And... yeah, we might have more gear on this character because we killed some monsters. I haven't done that with the other one. But anyway, we'll see if I continue with this one or the other. I have a friend with the other character, so we might use it. Alright, so this concludes the first part of the Rune-Midgard Chaos and history. The name is based on the character from the manga, the main character. He is just a swordsman currently, but he looks like that character in terms of his hairstyle and hair color. He has totally different gear, and I'm not sure if he can look as like the hero, but anyway, the idea behind the name was to have the same name as the main character of the manga, or Manwha, which is a Korean manga. Alright, see ya some other time. Hope you enjoyed this video and the first part of my Let's Play of Ragnarok Online. I have never played this game before, so this is the first time I've done this. I've played this part once before, but beyond this part I have never played anything. So going forward from here will be very exciting. Alright, see ya.